Okay, so we are going to start a new chapter, flow through pipes. As I told you earlier, that when a flow takes place in a pipe, there is loss of energy. We have seen it in Bernoulli's equation, right? It cannot be possible for an normal fluid. Ideal fluid, it is okay, the energy is conserved. But in normal Newtonian fluid, the energy decreases or energy is lost due to various factors. So in flow through pipes, we learn these factors which are responsible for the energy loss. Then we'll learn the Dupuit's equation and the equation for compound pipes. Okay. So overall, we are going to learn the how the flow is taking place in pipes and few concepts regarding that. Okay, so let's start. So as I said, that there is an energy loss when water travels, water or any fluid as a matter of fact travels from a section to other section, there is loss of energy. So there are various factors contributing for the losses of energy. Majorly, there is only one factor which is due to which there is a major loss in pipe, and there are several minor factors. Okay, so first we learn the major factor due to which the energy loss takes place, and after that we go to minor losses in the pipe. Okay. So energy loss in a pipe flow. So when fluid is flowing through a pipe, the fluid experiences some resistance due to which some of the energy of the fluid is lost. Okay. So this is classified as major loss and minor loss. So the major loss in the fluid takes place due to friction energy, friction due to friction of the pipe, due to friction. So if the pipe is smooth, the loss will be less. So it all depends upon the material of the pipe and also the viscosity of the fluid. But here we are talking about the external factors due to which the energy is lost. So the major loss is due to friction. So loss of head. Head is synonymous, analogous to energy. So the loss of the head in the pipes due to friction is called as is major loss. Okay, so it was calculated by Darcy Weisbach, and it is given by HF is equal to FL V square upon 2GD, where F is Darcy's coefficient of friction, L is length of pipe, V is velocity in the pipe, and D is diameter of the pipe. We'll derive this consequently. So, okay, we have seen the major loss in the pipe. Now, we'll see that what are the minor losses in the pipe. So, the loss of the head due to friction in pipe is known as major loss. Due to friction, solely due to friction, whatever energy loss is taking place is called as major loss, while loss of energy due to change of velocity of the flowing fluid in the magnitude or direction is called as minor loss of energy. As I stated many times in the class, that velocity is a vector quantity. So how come the velocity changes? There are two factors which can change the velocity due to change in magnitude or change in direction. Any of the criteria can cause to change the velocity vector in the flow. So how is the velocity going to change if we change the magnitude and direction? Okay, so there are seven minor losses due to which the velocity changes. So first is loss of head due to sudden enlargement. So when the pipe diameter suddenly is enlarged, okay, so for example, if the pipe diameter is earlier 100 mm and it is suddenly changed to 200 mm, suddenly, okay. This word is very important, that the loss of the head due to sudden enlargement. If there is a gradual enlargement, then there is not this much energy loss, which is lesser than sudden enlargement. The energy loss in gradual enlargement is very, very, very minute, while sudden enlargement causes energy loss. Okay. What is happening? The diameter of the section is changing, right? So diameter of the section is changing means what is happening? Q is equal to A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Q is constant. So A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, right? So A1 is changing from A1 to A2. Therefore, V1 will change, right? The proportion should be constant, right? A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 is equal to constant. So the proportion should remain constant. So if A1 changes, then V1 will also changes to V2. A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, right? So if the diameter of the section changes, the velocity also changes. Similarly, loss due to sudden contraction. These are similar, right? Sudden enlargement and sudden contraction. Loss at the head, loss of the head at the entrance of the pipe. When the water enters at the entry, so when the water enters the entry area or the starting area of the pipe, there is a loss of head, right? When the water is pumped from the source to the pipe, certainly there are factors which contribute to the loss of energy. Loss of head at the exit of the pipe, okay? Fourth loss. Same as the entrance, there is also loss of energy at exit. Then loss of the head due to obstruction in pipe. If there is some obstruction in pipe, the cross section of the flow changes. See, whatever changes the velocity will change. Whatever changes the velocity will cause energy loss. So if there is obstruction, the cross section area of the flow will change. Isn't it obvious? If the cross section area of the flow changes, then velocity changes and there is loss. Okay. So loss of head due to an obstruction in pipe. Sixth is loss of head due to bend in the pipe. Okay. If there is a bend in the pipe, what will happen? The direction will change. Up till now, what we have learned? Sudden enlargement, sudden contraction, entrance, exit and obstruction. Here, what is happening? First of all, the cross section area is changing. Here, due to bend in the pipe means what? The direction of the flow is changing. So there is, if the direction of the flow is changing, direction of the velocity is changing, and then it is consequently changing the velocity. So loss of the head due to bend of in the pipe, loss of the head in various pipe fittings. Various pipe fittings are there. There is also loss of energy due to that. It is, pipe fittings are like what? Joint between two pipes, right? So there is a loss of energy in that also. So in case of long pipes, the above losses are small as compared to head loss due to friction, okay? And hence they are called minor losses. So the value of minor losses is very, very negligible in front of the major loss in long pipes. So they are called minor losses and they can be neglected. Okay. But in case of short pipe, these losses should also be considered because they are relatively comparable to the major loss. Okay. So what we have learned up till now, we have learned what is causing the energy loss. First is major loss and second is minor loss. So major loss is due to friction and minor loss is due to velocity and change of velocity. And change of velocity can be caused due to change in magnitude of the velocity or change in direction of the velocity. And what are the causes of those? Loss due to sudden enlargement, sudden contraction, entrance of pipe, exit of pipe, obstruction in a pipe, bend and various pipe fittings. Okay, remember this question will be there for your exam. So it is an important question that what are the major and minor losses. So it is simple, you can write it in your exam. These seven losses and the friction loss. Okay, let's move ahead. Expression for loss of head due to friction in pipe. So we are calculating this HF is equal to FL V square upon 2GD. This is expression due to friction loss, right? So we are calculating now the friction loss. So consider a pipe section having cross section, same cross section, and two sections are there, 1-1 and 2-2. Okay. So we need to calculate loss of head due to friction between these two section 1 and 2. So what are the consideration in the derivation? V1 is velocity of the flow at section 1-1. L is length of the pipe between 1-1 and 2-2. D is diameter. F dash is friction resistance per unit wetted area per unit velocity. This you read properly. This will come later. Okay. HF is equal to loss of head due to friction, and P2, V2 are the values of pressure intensity and velocity at section 2-2. Okay. Parallelly to this, 1-1 section, same are the values at section 2-2. Okay. P1, V1 is at 1-1, P2, V2 is 2-2. Okay. So, let's apply the Bernoulli's equation in section 1-1 and 2-2. So, what is the Bernoulli's equation in 1-1 and 2-2? P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 is equal to P2 by rho g plus V2 square by 2g plus Z2 plus HF. Now, the pipe is horizontal. So, Z1 is equal to Z2. So, they'll cancel each other. V1 is equal to V2. So, these two terms will also get cancelled. V1 square upon 2g and V2 square upon 2g. So, what remains is P1 by rho g is equal to P2 by rho g plus HF, where HF is head loss. Now, obviously, the energy at section 1 is more than 2 as the flow is taking place from 1 to 2. And the quantity by which the energy is less at section 2, it is HF. So, you are adding the term HF in right hand side, means the energy at right hand side is lesser and you are adding something to equate it with energy at 1. So, HF will be equal to what? P1 minus P2 upon rho g. And consequently, rho g HF is equal to P1 minus P2. You get the equation 1. Okay. But HF is head loss due to friction, and hence intensity of pressure will be reduced in the direction of flow by friction resistance. HF is head loss due to friction, and the pressure intensity will reduce in the direction of flow. Okay, so pressure intensity will reduce in direction of flow is that is from 1 to 2. Okay. So, we are going to calculate that frictional resistance. What is the frictional resistance which is occurring between pipe section 1 and 2? We need to calculate. So, the formula is already given for frictional resistance. That is, frictional resistance per unit wetted area per unit velocity into wetted area into velocity square. So, what is the value of frictional resistance? Frictional resistance value is equal to what? The frictional resistance per unit wetted area, per unit velocity into wetted area into velocity square. This formula is already given. Okay. So, just you need to know the what is the formula for frictional resistance. You can by heart it. Okay. So, what is that? Is equal to F dash into pi dl into V square. Okay. We have taken frictional resistance F dash, which we are going to use here. So, is equal to F dash into pi dl. Pi dl is wetted area. What is the wetted area? Pi dl. Okay. How come the area is wetted area is pi dl? Look at the pipe. Pi d is the what? Circumference of the circle of the pipe into length of the pipe, right? that will be total weighted area, total weighted surface area, right? We are going to find out surface area, not volume, right? So pi d or 2 pi r is the circumference into length of the weighted area. Okay. So is equal to f dash into weighted area into v square. Okay. Now v square, they have taken a common value as v1 is equal to v2. We have just taken a value v. Okay. So what is the ultimate value? Is equal to f dash into PL. Pi d is perimeter. So we have put a value p instead of pi d. F dash into PL into v square. Now they are calculating the Darcy-Weisbach calculated basically this equation. So he calculated the forces acting at section 1-1 and acting at section 2-2. So what are the forces acting? Pressure force at section 1-1, that is P1 into A. Pressure force at section 2-2, that is P2 into A. Okay. And frictional force, that is F1, which we have calculated F dash into PL into P square. Okay. So we'll stop here today. We'll continue the derivation in the next class. I'll just share this PPT with you. You go through the PPT once and we'll continue tomorrow. Okay.